Yo, what's up? It's Jay Lyrickal back on the set again with another unboxing and review of a figure. Once again, I'm still going the lines of the WWE Elite Collection figures. There's four figures in that wave. I've already done two videos of two figures prior. Today, we're going to do the third figure in that wave. And today, I'm going to just jump right into it. We're going to unbox and we're going to review. And we're going to compare and contrast one of my favorites. One of the all-time greats to ever do it. The most electrifying man in all of sports entertainment. That's right, my man, The Rock. All right. Like I said, we're still going down the line of the Wrestlemania wave with the Build-A-Figure Nicholas. Now, what's interesting is that they always do a Rock figure. Like, this is a figure that has been repeated so many times, but it's like the guy comes back and he looks different, and he comes back, and it's like how they do with John Cena and with Roman Reigns. They make a million and one John Cena figures. They make a million and one Roman Reigns figures, and I've come to the conclusion that they really do it for the kids. I mean, I already have Rock figures. I'm going to show you guys later on in the video when I do a comparison with this guy. But yeah, this figure is actually pretty dope looking. It's similar to any other Rock figure of his recent look of the tattoos and the goatee and stuff like that. So let's jump right into it. I'm not going to take too much time because I actually want to do like a compare comparison with the other Rock figures that I have. Let's get it on. So yeah, like this Rock figure, pretty much similar to any Rock figure that came out the past couple years of his more recent look. But also includes, for the Build-A-Figure parts, the head and the Raw Tag Team Championship, which I actually like that they actually included the title belt with this Build-A-Figure. I think that's dope. As normal, you got the extra set of hands. That's normal. This Rock is the version of the Rock that fought John Cena at WrestleMania, the once in a lifetime, and also when he fought John Cena that year after. I forgot what number WrestleMania those two were, but yeah, he looks good actually. He looks really, really good. He also comes with the WWE Championship, his custom owned Rock Plates WWE Championship. So, let's see. So yeah, he's really just same. he looks like when he was in Fast and Furious. Like they got like that look of him. Like he was wrestling around that time that movie had came out. I think that's when John Cena and Rock had that match around the time that Fast and the Furious movie came out. But yeah, he looks good. He's highly detailed. And that's what I like about WWE Elites. They really make these figures heavily detailed with body sculpture, facial recognition, and any kind of accessories as far as like tattoos or any kind of attire that the wrestlers would wear to the ring. Yeah, his articulation is pretty much the same as the other WWE Elite figure videos that I did. He has legs go up and down, side to side. The arms, same up and down. They also go outward. What I like about this figure is the trunks. I like that they gave him the Brahma Bull on the front and on the back. Actually, I'm digging that. And the tattoo is heavily detailed as well on the back and the side and the front. And this Rock figure actually has the goatee. So he actually does look like when he was in Fast and the Furious. But yeah, this is actually This is a cool figure. Build-A-Figure parts are as followed. Build-A-Figure parts. Nicholas is the Raw Tag Team Championship. And the head of Nicholas, which is pretty spot on as far as like looks like this actually really does look like the young kid. The belt is cool. It's a soft plastic. It's more of a matte gray emblem on the belt. It's not really like a shiny gray. Like how they have for the old tag team championships, it's more of a shinier emblem piece. This one is more just like a matte. As you can see, there's really not no shine to that. But nonetheless, it's still great. He actually feels heavy. Got some weight to him. This is him with the title. The championship belt has a shine to it also. It's not like a matte plated. This is actually like a glossy look to where it actually shines like a real championship belt, which is cool. Now we get into the compare and the comparisons of other Rock figures. So this is the figure that I just unboxed. Here is a Rock figure that I've had for, oh my God, for years. I've had this Rock figure for years. This is my older one. And as you can see, with this having the goatee, this figure has the goatee and this figure doesn't. The trunks are different. The Brahma Bull logo is on this one. And then you have the Rock on the front. On the back, they actually both have the logo of the Brahma Bull, which is cool. Same boots. He's been wearing the same boots for years. Even when he came back, still had on the same boot. I'm not sure what year this figure is because I've had this figure for well over 10 years. I've had this figure for a long time. But it's the same, honestly, as far as like, you know, the details of the tattoo. It's definitely the same front, back, and side. Even the Brahma Bull tattoo is the same. Only difference is this figure has a goatee. With the logos being in silver, this one, no goatee, and the logos being in gold. So it's really pretty much the same with just a few, just some minor differences. I also have a 99 2000 version of Rock where he obviously had no tattoos. He had no facial hair whatsoever. And this figure, he actually has hair. This is the older version of the Rock with the Rock logo being the same and the Brahma Bull on the back. Like I said before, same boots. This man has not changed his boots since he's wrestled. When he became the Rock, he kept the same damn boots. So it doesn't matter what rendition of the Rock that you get, no matter what version of the Rock you get, you're still going to get the same damn boots. No difference. Now, also, I have a third Rock figure that is different from the one that I just opened. I have 2003 Hollywood Rock. And if you remember this version of the Rock, if you remember this gimmick was hilarious. I swear I loved Hollywood Rock. Hollywood Rock was phenomenal. Like his jokes, I mean, like we've always known Rock to be great on the microphone, but 2003 Rock was amazing. This is the Rock that fought Goldberg, who beat Stone Cold at WrestleMania, what is it, 19? Yeah, WrestleMania 19. And this Rock is amazing, where he actually has the light Caesar before he cut off all his hair. The tattoos are the same. The only difference with this Rock is this Rock doesn't have the chest piece. So like his tattoo wasn't fully finished at this time in 2003. Whereas when he came back in 2000, I think it was 2004 or later, he actually had the chest piece. But yeah, 2003 Hollywood Rock was hilarious. I love this Rock with the big belt buckle and the pants and the guitar. I actually have the guitar accessory as well. But yeah, these two, as you can see, different. It was a different time. It was a different era. Still the same guy. But the gimmick was way better for him, Hollywood Rock, than him coming back to WWE. I wasn't really... I wish, or I should say it like this. I personally wish that they kept the Hollywood Rock gimmick going for a little bit longer. I actually liked the gimmick. The gimmick was dope. The fact that he joked on Hollywood Hulk Hogan. That's right. He also fought Hollywood Hulk Hogan at No Way Out in 2003. That gimmick was amazing. When he came back to WWE, it was cool. Like, you know, he was in much greater shape. He was really, really built for movies and stuff like that. And I liked him coming back, but I wish they gave him a different kind of gimmick for when he came back. Like, I get it. Like, it was him coming back after so many years of not being in the ring, but I think him just coming back to be all about business, they could have done more with Rock for what he's worth, you know? I mean, he's done so many movies that they could have done more with his gimmick. My favorite Rock would be the 2003 Hollywood Rock. That's my favorite gimmick of all time. I love that gimmick. The Stone Cold Rock, where he was beefing with Stone Cold, was great also. But I really, really liked that Hollywood gimmick when they gave him that run in 2003. Him beating Stone Cold, him beating Hollywood Hulk Hogan, him unfortunately losing to Goldberg. You know, I wasn't really too fond of that, but I get it. They just put Goldberg in the WWE, so they had, you know, give him this unbeatable run. But I really wish, personally, that Rock won that match. If you feel different, let me know in the comments, but that's how I feel. I feel like with him being this Rock, Hollywood Rock, it would have actually sent him off better. Like, I came back, I beat Austin, I beat Hogan, but I lose to Goldberg. That's just me personally. I feel like they should have just had him keep going with that winning streak with this gimmick. That's it for this video. Tell me what you think. Tell me if you guys have this figure. Do you like the figure? Do you dislike it? Tell me if you have other figures of The Rock and which is your favorite figure. Once again, this is the newer WWE Elite Rock figure. Tell me what you think. And I'll be back with another video for the final figure of this wave. Can't wait to show you guys. And then at the end of that video, we're going to actually put all the pieces together to build the Nicholas action figure from WrestleMania. Peace out.